In this video, I'll be explaining basic biomechanics of cervical spine. Cervical spine can do so much complicated movement. Yes, they are very complicated, very precise, very sophisticated place. But before I jump into biomechanics directly, let me talk about basic anatomy and basic movement of cervical spine. First thing first, how many cervical spines do we have? How many? It is 7. Yes, we do have 7 cervical spines. The good way to remember is it's kind of breakfast time, right? 7 a.m. Yes, we have 7 cervical spines. Yay! However, I am not talking about cervical spine 1 and 2. These joints are very complicated. These are kind of exception. So I will talk about beneath cervical spine 2. So in between cervical spine 2 and 7. Oxford, the C1, C2. This complex is kind of exception. So C2 through C7. Good. And basic movement of cervical spine. What kind of movement can cervical spine do? It is flexion, extension. This is kind of yes movement. Flexion, extension. Or no movement, rotation. This is, you know, no movement. One more plane, side bend. You know, this movement, side bend. So cervical spine can do 3 plane movement. Yes movement, no movement, and side bend. However, in real life, we do not only do 1 plane movement. We can combine 2 or 3 planes movement, right? Maybe you do flexion at the same time, maybe you do rotation, or even you combine with side bend. So you can do 1 plane movement or 2 planes of movement or even 3 planes of movement. So this place is very complicated. Now let me jump into biomechanics. However, I just talk, it's very complicated place. So what do I talk about? I will talk about coupled movement of cervical spine. Coupled movement is when cervical spine moves, it does other movement. So let me explain about coupled movement. Now I have spine only. What kind of coupled movement I am talking about? So coupled movement is combination of side bend and rotation. I will say it again. Side bend and rotation. By the way, you are looking this model from this way. So this guy has face here. This guy has chest here. So as I'm standing now, there are 2 kind of coupled movement. Type 1 is when you do side bend left, this is my left side bend, rotation happens in opposite direction. So if I do left side bend, rotation is right rotation. I will say it again. Type 1, when you do side bend to the left, rotation happens in to the right, this way. So right side bend, left rotation. Left side bend, right rotation. This is type 1 coupled movement. However, cervical spine is not type 1. What is it? It's type 2. What is type 2? Let me explain. So type 2 is when you do side bend to the left, rotation happens in same direction. In this case, left side bend, left rotation. Right side bend, right rotation. This is type 2. Type 2 happens in between C2 and C7. Occiput, C1, C2 are different. I'm not talking about upper cervical biomechanics. So I'm talking about like normal cervical biomechanics. I will repeat again. What is type 1? Type 1 is left side bend, rotation happens the opposite direction. Right rotation, right side bend, left rotation. That's type 1. It's not cervical spine. It happens in thoracic spine and lumbar spine. So type 2, which is cervical spines, which is left side bend, left rotation. Right side bend, right rotation. This is normal function of spines. So if when you palpate cervical spine, it doesn't feel like it's doing type 2 movement. It's like type 1 movement. That can be dysfunction. The type 1, type 2 is a normal function for spines. So when cervical spine stucks in the type 1 position, that can be dysfunction. Cervical spine should perform type 2 movement. This is very, very important. I am just talking about just basic biomechanics of cervical spine. If you are interested in the biomechanics, there are so many more complicated movements. So if you are interested, you just Google it and look up for workshop. I am just talking about just basic biomechanics. So I hope this video helps your understanding of biomechanics of cervical spine. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.